Hello, everyone. I'm Rod Wortham, and welcome back to this edition of Race Face Driver Updates. Anthony Alfredo went NASCAR Xfinity racing on Saturday at Atlanta Motor Speedway in his Death Wish Coffee number 21 for Richard Childress Racing. I could give you the recap, but let's hear it straight from the driver.
Hey, what's up, everybody? Anthony Alfredo here. Just wrapped up the race here at Atlanta Motor Speedway in our Death Wish number 21 Chevrolet Camaro. Richard Childress Racing guys did a great job staying on top of it all day. We actually fought an issue just with the throttle earlier in the day. It was sticking a little bit, and when we had to, we fixed it, but we went a lap down from that. So unfortunately, by the time we gained that back, we got back where we belonged, just a little bit too late. But we fired off. We started 24th because the draw drove all the way up to 13th by the lap 20 competition caution, and we stayed out. I was having that issue, and it was just building really tight since the locker was staying locked up. And we overcame that, got a top 10 again. We finished 10th and had a great run at the end there to finish in the top 10. I had to drive really hard, and it was a lot of fun. I learned a ton. This track's not easy. I think we adjusted for that issue early and kind of went the wrong way, so I could be a little bit better at my communication next time, thinking about the long run. But nonetheless, I'm super thankful to be here, thankful for everybody's support, my race team, Death Wish, and I'm looking forward to the next week at Homestead.
That's three top 15 finishes, with two of them in the top 10 in his first three NASCAR Xfinity starts. I believe Anthony's off to a great rookie season with Richard Childress Racing, and they'll be back at Miami Homestead this weekend. Connor Mozak was back for a third time at Ace Speedway this year, but Saturday was for round two of the Cars Tour late model stock car series. Qualifying did not go as planned, and Connor took the green flag for the race at Ace 125 in 23rd position. That did not stop him from making a consistent march to the front. Connor kept his nose clean after dodging a couple of wrecks that happened around him, made a few key passes late in the race, and brought home the number 8 Nick Taylor Interstate Foam Junior Motorsports Chevrolet home in 11th place. Connor currently sets tied for second in points, only 8 points out of first, heading into this weekend's race at Hickory Motor Speedway. Caden Honeycutt made the trip to RPM Speedway to sling some dirt in his number 37 Reality Roofing Sport Modified. In his heat, he drove from 9th up to 3rd, but on the last lap, he got collected by a car that spun in front of him, ending his heat race. The team quickly made the necessary repairs, and Caden started the A-Main in 20th position and charged his way through the field, finishing in 4th. Grant Thompson made his pro late model debut for Grand American Race Cars in the Augie Grill number 112 at Five Flags Speedway. Grant qualified 6th for the feature against a stacked field of cars. The young Mobile driver ran a smart race, staying out of trouble, and brought home a 7th place finish in his first 100 lap event. He then raced at Montgomery Speedway, where he qualified the 112 in the 10th position out of 29 cars. Grant finished his second pro late model race of the weekend with another impressive top 10, bringing home another 7th place finish. Haley Constance was back in her 600 micro sprint at Deming Speedway, where in her heat race, she started 4th and worked her way to the front for the win. She then started 5th in the A main, where she battled the entire race and ended up finishing in the 5th position. Cassidy Hines made her Legends debut at Intermountain Speedway, but had to endure a 2-hour rain delay before taking the green flag in her first ever heat race, where she started 7th and finished 5th. In the A-Main, Cassidy started from the 14th position and drove her way to a top 10 finish in 9th place. Cassidy will make her second pro late model start this weekend at Irwindale Speedway in Irwindale, California. Well, that's it for this week's Race Face Driver Updates. And remember, if you've missed any of our shows, you can get caught up on raceface.tv on demand. Don't miss Race Face Spotlight on Thursday at 8 p.m. Eastern Time, this week featuring Avada, California driver Cassidy Hines. As always, we encourage you to support local racing in your communities. Don't forget to follow us on social media. We'll be back next week with more from your favorite Race Face drivers. So go out there and have a great race weekend. I'm Rod Wortham. Thanks for watching.